everyone, Kelley Lord here for this week's Raphy Report. Raphy isn't feeling too well this week, so I'm just gonna go ahead and do it by myself. So in national news, Raphy, I thought you were supposed to stay at home. You're still not looking too well.
Hey everybody, I'm Raphy Santos.
And I'm Kelley Lord.
I'm feeling much better now, and I'm ready to report the news.
I'm not feeling good at all, thanks to you.
Sorry. Just kidding. But you look awesome as a zombie, I have to say.
And thanks to you.
Oh, thank you so much. I did some really simple, believe it or not, zombie makeup on both of us.
Only took like a half an hour.
Not bad at all. This delicious blood that is on my lip is actually just corn syrup, so it's tasty and it's very safe. And all this rotting flesh going on all up in here is just toilet paper. Very simple tips that if you check out my blog sometime this week on theraphyreport.com, I'll show you how to do it.
Yeah, I learned a lot, so definitely check that out.
Sweet. Well, we had an awesome weekend all around. Alumni came through. It was a great homecoming weekend. I had a good time.
And very successful performance by you.
Thank you so much.
At the Spelling Bee. I went this Friday. It's a very interactive, fun show. I definitely think you guys should all go. There's still a weekend left.
Yes, we run through October 29th. Please come if you can.
Yes.
Well, our assumptions were right from last week about our awesome hockey team. They crushed Assumption College 4-1 on Friday and 5-1 on Saturday.
Yeah, I saw the Saturday game. It was really, really good, guys.
Awesome.
Congratulations. In international news, a natural disaster has taken an estimated 500 to 1,000 lives in Turkey this weekend. A 7.2 earthquake hit multiple villages in Turkey, crumpling multi-floor buildings, hotels, and a dormitory. Military aircraft are thankfully being deployed to rescue victims.
Well, I really hope that everyone's safe there. I know that I have a couple of friends in Turkey, actually, so I'm going to make sure that I check up on them, and we will, of course, keep you updated. Switching the news up a little bit, as per our makeup, I know I'm getting really excited for Halloween.
Me too.
Weekend. And there's a lot of really cool events coming up to keep it real spooky and fun.
Mm-hmm. Saturday, 29th, Fredonia's 66th Halloween costume parade will begin at 1 p.m. and will proceed down Temple Street to the Barker Commons. Individual marchers are encouraged to participate, so anyone can put on a costume and head on down there. Free cider and donuts will be provided under the gazebo after the parade.
Well, see, what you should do is keep your makeup on all week until the parade, and then you'll be set.
I mean, it seems pretty permanent, so.
I think so. This Saturday, October 29th, on the same day, from 9 a.m. to 12 p.m., we will be hosting Safe Halloween on Fredonia's campus. Now, this is because, as you know, trick-or-treating is actually banned for children in Fredonia, so what we like to do is provide a safe trick-or-treating experience. All of the practice rooms in Mason will be open. Essay groups, a lot of Greek life, Pride Alliance. We all have different rooms that we decorate, and we have different theme. Pride Alliance has a Disney theme, so we'll all be dressed up as fun Disney characters, and we pass out candy to all the neighborhood kids. It's a lot of fun. If you have kids, if you have younger sisters, nieces, nephews, come out, and it's all free.
And by the way, it's not just banned for little children. You guys, don't be the creepers going out door to door. You're probably the reason it's illegal here. So.
Exactly.
Later that day, Colleges Against Cancer is hosting a Halloween bar crawl from 6 p.m. to 1 a.m. Shirts can be purchased at 41 West Tuesday from 7 to 9 and Friday from 7 to 8:30.
Now, I feel like after the bar crawl, we probably look a little bit like this anyway, don't you think?
Yeah, definitely the black under my eye.
Right.
Yep, it's pretty close.
Right. Well, like we said, I'm very happy for half of Spelling Bee to be over, and hopefully I will come to you next episode with my new segment with Tom Laughlin from the Department of Theater and Dance. He will be seeing the show next week, so hopefully he'll recap on that also. And yeah, I hope to bring that to you very soon.
I'm very excited for that.
Switching up in international LGBT news, lesbian, gay, bisexual, and transgender advocates took over the rotunda at Cleveland City Hall on October 11th, honoring those who have made a huge difference in the community. Brian Tupaz, a former corporal in the Marines, was honored under the category of safety. Mary Beth Schwarz was honored for her social service work, as was Dr. Matthew Walsh for healthcare. The final award went to State Rep Nikki Antonio in the public service category. Speakers at the event included Rep Antonio, U.S. Attorney Stephen M. Dettelbeck, Director Blaine Griffin of the Community Relations Board, Ward 3 Counselor Joe Krimperman, and Mayor Frank Jackson. So everyone was rewarded beautifully at this event. Dr. Sfera also noted that a bequest of $400,000 of non-operating funds, bringing the center's endowment to over $500,000 that they've raised. She says that we are honored by the gifts of our community and know it's our responsibility to ensure that the center's work continues in the years to come and thrive in a very tough economy, she said. Special thanks to GayPeoplesChronicle.com for that story, which is a local LGBT newspaper in Cleveland.
Okay, great. Well, that's all we have this week for you guys.
We're also sponsored by Buster Brown Bean Company.
Yeah.
Show support. I know they actually just had their zombie prom this past weekend, and
I've heard
great things about that.
Great.
So thank you very much, and we'll be the undead until next episode.